Welcome to this video introduction to backtesting strategies with Qcaid. In this video, I will show you how to do a backtest and how to review its results. To do so, I will use the strategy that we created in the previous video. To run a backtest, click on the Upload the Strategy to Backtest button. A backtest configuration form will be displayed, where we can enter the test parameters. First, we select the backtest type. In this tutorial, we will only focus on the standard backtest. We'll explain the particularities of high precision backtests in one of our next videos. First, we select the backtest type. In this tutorial, we will only focus on the standard backtest. We'll explain the particularities of high precision backtests in one of our next videos. Next, we enter a name for the backtest. It may be convenient to enter a descriptive name to easily locate the file later on. Select the start and end date of the backtest. In this case, we can use the full year of 2014, from January the 1st. To December the 31st. Next, we apply the broker commissions. We can set a 0.08% commission on the amount of each operation. We can also set a slippage that will be applied to the price of all our trades, or change the initial funds. In this case, we will keep the default value. We will also request the download of the full details of the floating P&L. Keep in mind that this may slow down the completion of the backtest. At the top of the form, a message will show us what fields remain to be completed. Now it says we must select the instrument on which we perform the backtest. We will select the instrument from the list of available instruments by clicking the Choose button. We can search by name or by symbol. Click Choose. After selecting a value, and the selected instrument will appear in the form. The Finish button becomes enabled once the form is completed. When we click it, a dialog reminds us that we are going to run one backtest and asks for confirmation. After clicking Yes, an Uploaded Successfully notice will appear in the bottom right corner. In order to view the backtest report, we must open the backtest analysis window by pressing the Open Report Window icon. The backtest we have just run can be found in the report window. When clicked upon, its results appear in the backtest results view. In this case, we have run just one backtest, but in following videos, we'll see how to run a backtest group to optimize the strategy parameters. Double-click on the result for the full backtest report, and all the information will appear at the bottom, organized into tabs. The Report Information tab shows the backtest setup, such as the time period or the commissions. Next is the Performance Summary tab. This tab contains different ratios to analyze the results of the backtest. In the Trades tab, each transaction is listed with details such as the time and price of opening and closing, and the profit of the operation. Finally, the Orders tab shows a rundown of every order and its events. This information will be even more relevant when analyzing high-precision backtests. In addition to this information, charts showing the strategy's evolution are available on the pane on the left. Firstly, the equity curve shows the evolution of funds after each transaction. The value before commissions are applied is shown in blue, and the result after commissions is red. The second chart shows the evolution of the maximum drawdown in a similar fashion. Finally, since we requested to download the P&L data, we can review the evolution of each position in a chart. By clicking and dragging, we can define an area to zoom into. This is all for now. In the next video, we will see how to optimize the parameters of this strategy by running backtest groups. Until then, thank you for watching.